When government engages in policy mechanisms to try to alter the economy, sometimes those policies can do more than expected. When we look at changing aggregate demand in particular, what we're trying to do is shift at least one of the components of aggregate demand. Aggregate demand is made up of four things: consumption, which is household spending; investment, which is typically business spending; government spending; and net exports. Net exports are the foreign or the international component of the GDP. When government increases spending, that's going to necessarily increase aggregate demand by changing the government spending part of aggregate demand. But it can also affect other parts of aggregate demand. One of the more direct things that it can affect is consumption spending. If government spends money, it has to spend it on something, and presumably it's going to spend money to buy things, which means the incomes of households will go up. So not only will government spending increase, but consumption can increase as well. The ability of government policy, of government spending, to affect the aggregate demand will then become dependent upon how much of that newfound income people decide to spend. This is sometimes referred to as the marginal propensity to consume. The marginal propensity to consume is simply a fraction, a percentage of how much of your income you're going to spend. The rest of it is typically left to savings, which is called the marginal propensity to save. So if you decide to spend half of your income and save half of your income, the marginal propensity to consume would be 0.5 or 50%, and the marginal propensity to save would be 0.5 or 50%. Now, when government decides to spend money, they decide. When government decides to spend, they have to take this into consideration. What's the marginal propensity to consume of households? Because this can have an impact on the effectiveness of government policy. So, the government looks at the number they call the multiplier effect. The multiplier effect depends upon the marginal propensity to consume. Because if people spend a large portion of their income, that's going to increase the effectiveness or increase the power of government spending. So, let's say we have a situation where government is going to spend a certain amount of money. They want to know how much of that money is going to trickle down into the consumer's pocket that they're going to spend, and thereby increasing aggregate demand even further. So they calculate this multiplier effect. The multiplier effect is equal to a fraction of 1 divided by 1 minus the marginal propensity to consume. Roughly 70% of GDP comes from consumption spending. So let's just assume that the marginal propensity to consume for the average household is 0.7. That means that the multiplier effect in this example would be 1 divided by 1 minus 0.7, or 1 divided by 0.3. If we figure that out as far as the multiplier effect itself, 1 divided by 0.3 gives us 3. So what we're saying is that the multiplier effect of any government spending would be 3. So let's say the government decides they're going to spend $100 billion. We take that $100 billion times 3 to give us the multiplier effect of $300 billion. So government spending may increase the GDP by $100 billion, but the multiplier effect implies for us that it's actually going to increase GDP by $300 billion. That's very important for government to understand, because if they're going to shift the aggregate demand curve to a certain level, they may overshoot this or vastly undershoot it if they don't take into account the marginal propensity to consume of the general population.